So in this video, we are going to talk about how to add footnotes and endnotes in Word. I am using the 2016 version, but the 2013 version will work as well. So let's get started. I'm going to go up here to the top of my document, and I'm going to click here in this paragraph where it says resort. I'm going to click at the end of it, and now let's add a footnote. To do that, we go up here to our References tab and select the Insert Footnote button, which is this AB with the little one above it. I'm going to click on that, and it's really that easy, folks. What it did is it added a little number one up where the text was. We'll jump back up there in a second. And then it created a little footnote here at the bottom of the page. And then there's the little number one, and now I can actually add some more information here. So I'm going to do that now, and I'll see you on the other side. Welcome back. So I just added a little note here about our content, which is travel. And now let's scroll up to show you what I was talking about. See here next to the word resort, it added that little one. So it added that and it dropped us down here to populate the footnote. So easy. Love it. We didn't have to do any formatting ourselves. It did it all for us. Now let's try that one more time. Make sure you got it. I'm going to go up here and let's see where it says right here. For the individual traveler as well as any associated public health. So I'm going to click at the end of that one. And watch this. I'm going to click Insert Footnote again. And Word is smart. It knows we've already added one footnote. So it's automatically using the number two and adding it next to our number one. So we can add another note here. It is best to consult a travel medicine specialist. Done. Just like that. Awesome. Now you might be like, Melody, what is a footnote or an endnote? Well, footnotes and endnotes are used in documents to provide further information, as we can see here, which is usually like explanatory text or a reference to text in a document. Like if you're citing something and you got it from an article, you throw it down at the bottom of the page would be another example. Now I'm going to go ahead and add a few more here. I'm going to speed it up so you can watch, but also not drag this video out. So let's get to work. Okay, welcome back. Now, the main reason why I had you go ahead and watch this happen versus just telling you to see you on the other side again is because I wanted you to notice that Word is very intuitive when it comes to this stuff. So I went ahead and I had added a footnote here, and technically it was my third one. And when I first added it, you would have noticed it was number three. But then I went back and I added some footnotes earlier, like in this column, and right here, and it's applying the appropriate order based on where it's at in the page. So since this came before these items, it put number three first. So it started renumbering based on where it's at in the page, which was great. So I didn't have to do it in any kind of chronological order. It kept up with me. Awesome. Now let's go up to the top of the document here. And then I'm going to click this button here that says next footnote. So another neat feature is you can click on that and it will take you to the next footnote. And if I click on it again, it will take me to the next one and so on. And if I click the down arrow here, I can see some more options. So if I click previous footnote, it will take me backwards. So I can go all the way to number one. And there I am. Behavior is a critical factor. I'm at my number one item. Now to delete a footnote, we can just find the footnote on our document. Like let's pick on number three. If I go here and I hit delete, and then you notice it highlights it, and I hit it one more time, it will remove not only the little number three here at the top, it removed it down here at the bottom and renumbered everything else. Again, very intuitive. Awesome. Now that we know how to add them, let's talk about what they are. Because I'm sure you're like, wait, Melody, so what are footnotes and endnotes? What's the difference? Now, if we would have selected here where it says insert endnote, then it puts it on a final page. So for endnotes, all your notes are at the end of the document. For footnotes, all of your notes are above the footer. That's the difference, folks. And one more little note before we close this video. If we click on the More button here to expand our launcher to expand the footnotes and endnotes, we can see we can do some modification or formatting if we would like. We can choose the number format if we'd rather have Roman numerals or letters. We can select that there, or we can select a custom mark for our footnotes or endnotes. We can tell it where to start, what type of numbering format to use, and whether it's to this section or to the whole document, and we can tell it where to stick the footnotes, whether it's the bottom of the page or below the text itself. So just know you can customize it even further, but what I love about this feature is that it's really good as is, so we don't have to do too much manual manipulation in order to get a good end product. And that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. In the next video, please stay tuned for that one. That one's a good one. We're going to talk about inserting citations. For those of you that still have several essays to write in your future, or maybe at work you're having to write a lot of reports, this will save you a lot of time. So stay tuned for that one. Until then, I hope you all are having a fabulous day, and I will catch you later.